House members put a government phone program under the microscope. Lifeline, a 28-year-old federal assistance program giving low-income households access to a phone, landline, or cell.
Lifeline support can be the only means for regularly staying in touch with a doctor, applying for a job, or contacting 911.
Jessica Gonzalez used it a decade ago after she was laid off.
A phone line where someone can call me and get a hold of me for opportunities and for educational opportunities was huge.
You helped pay for this $2.2 billion expense with a portion of the federal universal service charge on your phone bill. In recent years, reports of abuse and waste have given Lifeline a bad rap. People had multiple free phones, even though there's a one per household limit. Some lawmakers say it's time to disconnect.
You're doing a terrible job of marketing it because you have lost the public opinion war on this. And we can't, and it's tough to get the genie back in the bottle.
But supporters say the FCC reformed the program, safeguarding it from fraud and verifying eligibility. But we found issues still exist. An FCC official says service providers won't say how much they profit from the government's free phone program. And when lawmakers asked how much will Lifeline cost next year, the FCC didn't know. There is legislation in the House to end Lifeline altogether, but there are also bills to expand it, even to include internet access.